Hello everyone, I'm Shreyas Doshi. I'm a product manager here at Google, and I work on AdWords, various parts of AdWords, including the AdWords API. So let's get started. Today I want to basically leave you with three key messages with regards to the AdWords API. The first one is that we've actually been very busy since we launched the AdWords APIs, but the key thing I wanted you guys to walk away with, key message, is that you need to start taking advantage of these new features. We've actually taken into account a lot of your feedback and incorporated that in these new versions of the API. Second is that since we've launched these new versions of the API, it basically implies that the old versions of the API have to go away. And so there's a migration coming up. For instance, we are going to start sunsetting the remainder of V13 and V2009 as these new versions launch. And the third key message is that you know, while we've improved the API, we realize that there are a lot of other problems that you face that aren't yet addressed. All right, so let's start with what's new with the AdWords API. The first one is preferred AdWords API pricing. So that is something we launched for agencies and SEMs in May of this year. Preferred pricing is a way in which you can get basically unlimited use of the API. So it's an application process. You apply with us, and then as long as you meet certain requirements, we will basically give you unlimited use of the API for free. Second one is V13 is gone. It's not really gone. It's almost gone. There are about three services that remain. And so we'll talk about what we're going to do with those three services. And the third is we've launched V2010.03 as well as V2010.08 more recently. And so let's look at the new features that we've released in these versions. So the first one, and the one that I'm very excited about, is the report service. So this is the new version of the report service. And the key thing about this version is that it's significantly faster than the V13 report service. Because it's built on our new architecture, it will enable us to expose features much faster, so expose new fields much faster than we've done in past versions of the API. Second one is these exciting ad formats, product ads, which is essentially product listing ads and product extensions. And these are actually ads, and you see they have images associated with those products on Google Search. It's a compelling ad format, and we launched support for this in V2010.08. Another feature is remarketing. This is a very interesting feature, and essentially what it lets you do is it lets people who browsed your site, who probably did not buy something or basically end up in a conversion event, it lets you target those users. Because by definition, they would be more engaged and more interested in your products. We've exposed a new service called the User List service, which essentially lets you target users and converts browsers and searchers into buyers for you. Bid Simulator is a feature which we launched in V2010.03. And we also launched AdGroup Bid Simulator in V2010.08. And essentially what that lets you do is, as the name indicates, it lets you simulate what your traffic might have been for different values of bids. Add sitelinks. Sitelinks are another compelling new ad format, and they look a lot like just general text ads. But what you'll see is they actually have four links at the bottom of the ad. And so what that lets you do is it no longer limits you to sort of the landing page or the home page or whatever it is that you have in the destination URL, but you can actually take the user to specific locations within your website and hopefully get better conversions that way. This is a feature that a lot of advertisers have been very excited about, and it's also available in the API. Phone extensions, this is very relevant for, say, the local use case, where a lot of times advertisers have told us, look, a click on my website or for my website is interesting, but what I really care about in some cases is a call to my business. And so what this lets you do is it lets you associate a phone number with your ad as an extension. And with that, you can actually include that phone number in the text ad, and it'll show up when the user is using a high-end mobile device, like an iPhone, for instance. There's a ton of other new stuff. We've launched a new traffic estimator service. There are a couple of other things like enhanced CPC, target CPA, and all of the information about this is available in the docs, of course, and also on the blog. And then we have some beta features that we've launched recently. One is AdWords Campaign Experiments. This is a feature that advertisers have been asking for a very long time from AdWords. What it does is it lets you run A-B tests, live A-B tests. And so you can basically, you know, instead of trying to guess what would happen if you set your bid to a certain value, you can actually try it as an A-B test. And then see what performs better and more sort of in concert with your advertising goals. Change history. This is a feature which basically lets you download changes that happened to your account, to specific accounts. In the past, you guys have told us, look, every night I have this job that downloads the entire campaign structure. And sometimes it's a waste because maybe only a few things in the campaign have actually changed. We've heard that feedback in the past, and we've been working on exposing this service. What it does is it lets you query via the API for specific entities that have changed. And so you can say, give me a list of changes that happened since a particular date or in this time range. And then it will give you the IDs of those entities, and then you can only pull those entities instead of pulling your entire account structure. And then the last beta feature is a partial failure support. The idea is, let's say you have you submit 1,000 operations to us, and you know 10 of them somehow fail for one reason or another. Maybe they violate some policy rule. Instead of your entire call failing, what this will do is it'll only fail the faulty operations. This is only exposed in one service right now, but over time we'll start exposing it in more and more services. So again, the key message that I want to convey is that you should start using and taking advantage of these features as soon as you can. So when you go back, I would encourage you to talk to various people in your organization and get these features on your roadmap so you can take advantage of better automation, more features in the API, and more efficiency.